greetings and salutations. How have you been? I'm Lady, and I am not a professional. I'm just a friendly lady. I like your shoes. I like your face. Confidence. The literal definition of confidence: feeling or believing that you can rely on someone. Firm trust. Wrong definition. It's not what we're talking about. The more relevant one states, a feeling of self-assurance arising from one's own appreciation of one's own abilities and qualities. Also, ignore my really big stupid hoops. I found them and thought they would be hilarious. Allow me to be your dear friendly lady and devote this upcoming video around the topic of confidence and how to overcome not having any. I spoke about this in my last video about the huge mess of bullying and how to overcome it, and I kept hinting at having faking confidence and gaining it, and I talked about it a lot more than other tips that I have mentioned in that video. I actually struggled with confidence a lot in my earlier years. I still kind of have a little bit of a struggle here and there, but definitely not as much as I used to have in my earlier years, especially in school. Anybody can have confidence issues at any age at all and for any old reason, and I will help provide examples and solutions to helpfully help you in your journey of gaining confidence, even if it's just a little bit more confidence. We'll get there. When you lack confidence, it actually shows. Something about your aura, it just says that you, well, lack confidence. There are a lot of things that can come from that, and they're not exactly the best things that are to have been had. You could have an issue with getting a job. You could be a target to more bullies. You could seem from the outside perspective as someone who is not capable of surviving various situations. Relationship troubles, having the actual job that you went in for that interview for a couple of weeks ago and they never called you back. It seems to be a really big point of judgment for people. They seem to judge a lot about your confidence level as to who you are, sadly. People will judge a book by their cover very often in this scenario. I remember when I was younger, of course we have to remember just a little bit here. When I was younger, I had an issue with a presentation in class. A couple of times, actually, because of my confidence. I had just barely passed, even though I was maybe that one student who actually went out of their way to actually study the topic material and actually present a presentation with a lot of information, as opposed to my classmates who were clowning around and didn't actually do much, and they had bullcrap for a presentation and they put it together sloppily last minute, 10 minutes before bed, and they still managed to pass because of the way that we presented them. We're different. The person who did the crap job presented it with gusto, and I was like, and that is the, yeah. It didn't end well, obviously. Body language is a very serious thing when it comes to having a lack of confidence. Looking subservient in the eyes of other people is not the best idea. People who have an ego problem and want to feed their ego will target you at your expense, and you bet that they will take advantage of you. People who are looking to use you and people who are looking to abuse you will be targeting you more if you look more subservient. When you look subservient, you have the body language, you're slouched and you don't actually want to look at people in the eye. And when you're not looking at them in the eye, they have all the right to do things when you're not looking at them because you're not looking at them. You know, when you're constantly being stared at and you don't want to do things because you know that your mom is constantly looking at you, and you know that feeling when the teacher is staring at you from across the room and you're going to stop texting and put your phone away? When the teacher's not looking, what do? Take your phone out. When your mom's not looking, what do? Take the food off the shelf and eat it anyway. There's a lot of things that people think that they can get away with when you're not looking at them. When you're not making eye contact with them, it's pretty much the same thing. At least from what I noticed, I could be very wrong. Some people will do things in front of you, no matter who you are and what you're doing. those people are a-holes. And when you seem like you are not looking at someone, you seem really not sturdy in your beliefs. This can be a hindrance when you're looking for a job. When you go into an interview and you sit... They're not really gonna wanna hire you because you lack confidence in your own ability to do the job that you have come into the interview for. When your chest is sunken in and when your head's all slouched down, you look like you're going to be obedient for whatever the heck they want you to do. That's where people who are going to use you come in. That's not a very good idea. It's all because of the body language of someone who lacks the confidence. A lot of stuff can go snowballing downhill very fast, and that's... Also, I noticed that when you show a body language of someone who lacks confidence, you have a very low success rate of your crush, who you are asking on a date, actually saying yes. It just sort of happens. If you are indeed shy, and you actually don't have too much of a foundation to base your confidence on, and you seem like you have no reason for the confidence, that's where you could have an issue. You feel all ugly and weak and stupid and this and that, and you feel like no matter what you do, you have no reason to have confidence. But I can assure you that there is definitely some ways to have confidence, no matter who you are and what you feel about yourself. First off, take a step back, and actually take a step back. Imagine that you are not you, but you are someone who is equal to you, but not you. Doesn't have to be someone higher than you, it doesn't have to be someone lower, but someone of the same status, maybe a clone or so, looking at you from the outside. What do you see? Who are you? Do you actually know who you are? Do you acknowledge who you actually are? You are Sarah, the girl with too many shoes, or you're Jared, the boy who doesn't get enough sleep. Not that. Sarah, you know you're strong. The fact that you were dealing with your nagging family and your annoying little brother over the holidays and you are strong enough not to go off on them. And Jared, you know you're brave. You stepped in and stepped on that spider that your little sister was crying about in her bedroom before she ran out. So technically, you're Sarah the strong, and you're Jared the brave. You see how that works? You have to look at the positive and sometimes funny things that you don't actually pay attention to, such as the things that you do every day. You actually have the ability to do them when others won't. It's sometimes the moments that you have to roll your eyes at because you do them every day. You overlook them. It's like saying Bruce, the guy with a lot of money, or Diana, the girl who was a nurse, just because they got used to fighting crime every day and raining justice down on everyone every single day of their lives. Bruce, the crime-fighting Batman, and Diana, the justice-wielding Wonder Woman. You are more than you think. Remember that. Nobody in the world is worthless. I can promise you that. Not a single soul. And before you start thinking, oh, I don't have that many friends, or any friends at all, or I didn't have enough dates this year, or any dates at all, numbers are just stats. Basing your confidence off of numbers is just as silly as a director basing the quality of their play that they have set to perform in a theater with the amount of chairs that exist in the auditorium. If you have 3,000 chairs in this auditorium and you are set to perform at a certain date and only 100 people show up, basing your confidence on numbers is just as silly as thinking that just because 100 people showed up that they did not care about who you are. Your play was good to you, right? You did all that hard work, right? Are you proud of yourself, right? Yeah, you should be proud of yourself. Don't base off of the fact that those couple of extra thousand people didn't show up and fill the auditorium. It's just maybe you gave them the wrong address, or maybe they are just actually not very good friends. Those 100 people came and gave you the time of their day to come and support you and your play. Those people matter more than the rest of the numbers. Numbers are numbers. It's always about quality over quantity. If you have no friends, obviously, you don't actually need them. I would rather see you go out and have people who actually give a crap as opposed to just having a number to go around and boast, when actually that number isn't very true. Also, if you notice that you have a lot of friends and they don't actually show up and care for you and show up to the play that you are performing in your theater, you might want to take a step back, but stay in your own shoes and look at the situation at hand. Are they actually using you? Are they weighing you down? Are they good for you? Or are you only good to them? There are a lot of people who are going around actually getting used by their friends instead of actually having friends. Friendship is a two-way street. If you are only going down one way to help them out and they're not helping you out, you should probably go down a different street where it's actually not a one-way. There are people out there who will use the kind people who actually have a lack of confidence and their subservientness, and they want to produce someone who is going to give them stuff all the time and enable you to have no confidence, and they won't boost you up just so they can have their own way. And they're not actually going to help you out. They're going to continue to suck the life out of you. Make sure that you are not getting used by your friends. Quality over quantity. Remember that. And people who do not actually feel like they have something to give in their confidence, fake it until you make it. This is the biggest thing that I noticed that helped me out a lot. Have you ever heard of that silly notion, that weird make-believe thing that people say is make-believe? Misery loves company. Smiling makes your mood better. Smiling helps other people smile. Contagious laughter. All of that. Faking confidence can actually help you get the confidence that you did not have in the first place. I once had a job in communications where there was an incredibly tricky voice-to-text machine that we had to deal with on a daily basis. There was an issue that if you did not say your screw-ups with gusto and confidence, you would actually risk screwing up the rest of the voice recognition system for a short period of time, as it was trying to figure out who the heck was just talking to it because it didn't sound like you for a second. For an example, if you were to hear something and you had to recite it to the machine, and you heard or read, "Tomorrow I am going to the Oracle," and somewhere in your brain during the process of reciting that or rewriting it into the machine, you hear or say, "Pineapple," you had better say pineapple as if you actually meant to say pineapple, because if you hesitate or screw up with the machine, go quiet, stutter, anything that wouldn't sound like you meant to say it, it would actually screw it all up. And people were actually monitoring you on your job about that all day long. So no matter how freaking silly it sounds, you had better say it with the most confidence that you've ever had in your life, or you would actually risk having a bad performance on your job. That's how I feel about faking confidence. You had better fake that you are the best screw up you have ever seen in your life, because in the end, you will actually have the confidence to no longer feel like the screw up you feel like you were right now. You're not a screw up, by the way. I'm just trying to use it as an example. Body language is what I mean. I need for you to stand tall and stick your chest out and put your chin in the air, or the lack of, and speak like a radio announcer or a customer service agent, and really force that eye contact on everybody you meet. Really get yourself visibly looking like you're confident, and soon you will be smiling despite fear all the time, because that's how habits work. And when you go somewhere with all of that confidence and someone stops you and says, "Oh, I like how you speak," or, "Oh, you look really tough," you're actually gonna start feeling like it, and you'll actually have something to base your confidence on. Just because you faked it and someone said something nice, you now know what you can base your confidence on. Now, don't go around being cocky and actually having to prove that you're a tough guy by beating someone down, but actually take that with you and say, "Huh, I am Jared, the tough badass. And I am Sarah, the communications expert." See where I'm going? Trust me, when I say fake confidence and the fact that it had helped me in my bullying and getting over it and stopping the bullies from ever bullying me again, I actually became noticed as smart, intelligent, and funny, because that's what people were noticing me to be. And so I took that and I ran with it. And then I improved myself in the future and I became, I guess, smart and funny. Or at least I try to be. when people started to say that, oh, you're funny, I actually tried to be funny and screwed up a lot along the way, which made people laugh. And then I learned from my mistakes, and whenever I have the right conversation, I can usually make a crowd fall over. Not saying that I'm going to become a comedian, but it just sort of happens. Also, a really, really, really weird tip that I have to share with you is music. Actually, the music you listen to can actually help you out in a variety of ways. If you listen to dramatic music, something very powerful, Woodkid, actually, if you know the artist Woodkid, he seems to really help with the feeling of being a hero, and it will help you feel more like that superhero type of person with confidence. And I used to listen to music every single day on my commute to school and on my commute back, just uplifting myself, enlightening, and convincing myself that I am a hero, and this is my soundtrack, my theme song. And then it just sort of reflected through how I was carrying myself, and it turned more into confidence. The music, it went through my ears, it went in my brain, it went to my heart, it went to my bloodstream, and next thing you know, I'm glowing like a freaking sunflower. And that's how you get me. Confident and weird. And that's how you get weird fake confidence from music, I guess. I began to reflect the music I was listening to. This might or might not help exactly, but you know, it's kind of worth it that I'd try to make a video about it. Hopefully that this topic or things that I have mentioned you have not at least heard before. I tried not to incorporate things that Google has said to do, simply because Google is vast and it repeats itself a lot. If I wanted to give a Google response, I would just title it Google Says. Nobody's perfect, trust me, but if you can be anything, be you and be happy about it. Because who else is gonna be you but you? I can't be you. I don't think the person over there can be you. You gotta be you, and you gotta be you. And you gotta be a happier you. Next time you go for that job interview, do what I do. Always tell yourself, I'm getting this job, and this job will get me. I will ace that presentation. That presentation needs me to present it. And I'm going to get that date because I love that date a whole lot. And they might like me too. Dang it. If you would like to see more videos on this topic, feel free to like the video. It's not exactly necessary, it doesn't actually do anything. It just lets me know that you are supporting this topic and that you would like to see more of it. If you have any tips or tricks that would help out with this topic of how you had gained confidence after not having any confidence, please let me know in the comments below. And if I end up making a series to this video, I will feature your comments. comments in the next video on this topic. And be sure to subscribe to keep up to date as to when that video will be coming out, so that way you know when your comment will be featured. Thank you so, so, so much for watching, and have a glorious rest of your night and or day. I'm Lady, and I'll stop bothering you for now.